Hello, my name is LaToya Faustin, and I am the executive director of She Built This City. We have been celebrating Women in Construction Week and all of the amazing women in our networks who are out there, boots on the ground or blazers in the office, wherever your role may be within the construction space. One of the pillars of She Built This City within our pledge for equity, 50-50 by 2030, is just empowering women to be able to go and create their own businesses and have the opportunity to be able to build legacy for them and their family. We discuss often how construction is one of those spaces where just like a lawyer, you know, once you get your certifications and your license, you can go work for another corporation if you want to, but you also have the wherewithal to start and run your own business. Many of the women we've been highlighting this week are doing just that. And so just to support those efforts of those of you who may be thinking about going into business on your own, and those of you who've already launched but want to go to that next phase, we've invited our friend and partner, Nicole Dillard from U.S. Bank here to discuss what are some of those business fundamentals of starting a bank, starting a business, not starting a bank, starting a business, and then how do we take it to the next level? Nicole is a business development consultant, and so she is the right woman for the task today. Nicole, welcome and thank you so much for being here.
Thank you so much for having me. So again, my name is Nicole Dillard. I'm a business development consultant with U.S. Bank. I have been in the industry for about 14 years, started in the consumer banking side, and really just grew a passion for working with small business owners, just seeing some of the challenges they face, but also just seeing people's dreams come to reality. And so I moved into the business banking space 5 years ago, and I have not regretted it. It's been just such a great experience seeing so many different people, bring their dreams to fruition and being part of that process. And so, yes, I'm with U.S. Bank, been with the bank for the last 4 years. And I specialize in working with small business owners, either from the startup phase to growth and anywhere, you know, kind of in between.
Wonderful. Yes, no, you are the woman of the hour. And these are there's so many components to what it means to start a business. And we were just talking, you know, just about whether you are thinking about it. And then when you launch, usually within those two phases, they're usually blended from you working for someone else and you working on your own, and you don't know all of the business foundations that you need to set yourself up for success to be qualified for future lending opportunities. So, Nicole, can you talk us through, you know, that person who's desiring to start their own business or maybe is doing a little bit on the side and wanting to take that full leap? What are some of the business basics they need to consider for banking to be able to launch successfully so that set themselves up for success in the future?
Absolutely. So I was saying that, you know, you don't have to be perfect to start, but you do have to be prepared, right? And so one of the main things that I would say is that really, obviously you don't have to have $1 million in the bank, but making sure that you are in a financial position to, you know, kind of make that leap from working for someone else to going out on your own. And so I'd say from going from that, you want at least to try to look to have 6 months to a year of your living expenses saved, if not more, if that's possible, in order before you kind of leap off, because there is some, you know, there's some time in between, you know, profitability and starting off, right? There is going to be a gap of time where you're just going to be working and may not see as much profit in the beginning stages. And so the basics as far as getting started is you want to make sure that you get your EIN, you know, established, and then get registered with your state. And that's something that you can do on your own. I know there's a lot of companies that charge for that, but it is something that you can do on your own. Pretty simple to go to irs.gov to get your EIN. And then you'll want to work with an attorney, an accountant, to kind of determine what type of structure you want to have for your actual business. And so that would be the first step. The other piece is really just making sure that you have a team, right? You're an expert at your business. But it's important to have experts in their various professions. And so I've already mentioned an accountant and a CPA, but I also believe that it is important to have a business banker as you start the process and are looking to, you know, kind of understand the basics, the financial basics, you know, having someone who's part of your team that can actually give you some guidance and resources as you look to grow. And so one of the basic things that I would suggest is setting up a business banking account, right? So a lot of people start the business, they're running everything through their personal account. And there's a couple of reasons why you don't want to do that. One, accounting or tax purposes. But two, really understanding your business is going to require for you to separate it out from your personal life, right? You really want to understand what you have coming in, what you have going out, really understand your profitability. And one of those other components is making sure that you have a profit and loss statement every single month. And so that way you can kind of track your trends. That's something that you can do on your own, or again, you can hire an accountant that can assist you with that. The other thing is starting to establish business credit. One of the main mistakes or a mistake a lot of business owners make is believing that there is a separation between personal and business credit, but you will need to work on your personal credit if you have some challenges there in order to build business credit. Because most institutions are going to look for you to have strong personal credit before they give you a business loan or business credit card. But once you have that personal credit established, there's a couple of different ways that you can go about funding your business depending on the scale or the expenses that you might have involved. You can do an SBA loan, and with the SBA loan, they're going to look for you to have, or we or any institution is going to look for you to have a strong business plan, and there are several resources for that. There are SCORE offices in most states, which is an SBA office that will help you with developing the business plan, but they're also going to want to see projections to kind of see, you know, when will your business become profitable? Are you actually going to be in a space to be able to repay the loan? So you have a business plan, the projections, strong personal credit, and, you know, some ability to put, you know, to basically put your own capital into the deal. Let's say, for example, you need a $50,000 piece of equipment. You're going to want at least to have 10% of that or $5,000 of that to put down into the business when you first start off. And so you can get an SBA loan for startup funding, but you also can start with like a business credit card. And there are lots of business credit card options out there. We have one that's actually no interest or a promotional offer with no interest for 0%. For 18 months. So 18 months, no interest. And so that's a good way to start the business off, get low interest. And I will say that if you need funding, like significant funding, you're going to want to kind of secure that on the front end because after you know, you've already started the business, then we're going to look at financial statements, that P&L that I talked about, things like that to really gauge your ability to repay the loan. Whereas in the beginning phases, you go SBA, you can go off of your projection. So really understanding everything that you're going to need from a cost standpoint and doing that at the very early onset of starting the business is going to be important.
You've just given us so many nuggets here to prepare and to consider. I really like how you opened this, as you don't have to be perfect, but you do need to prepare for what that looks like. And having people on your team that can support and be the expert, because I can imagine I have a background in business and I was slightly overwhelmed with the list of things to do. But if that is not your background, you know what your specialty is, you need to surround yourself. You don't have to do it all. I think that's the note that I think here is that you don't have to do it all. There are people out there who can support you with that process. I mean, starting with a business banker is a good place to at least begin those conversations.
Yeah. And really do your research, right? You know, there are tons of banks out there, right? But you really want to position yourself to actually have a business banker. It really is important. You know, you can go into the branch, there's, you know, bankers there, but really do your research, find a bank that actually is going to take an interest in you as an individual business owner and is willing to partner with you, because your banker is part of your story, right? We can speak on your behalf. We're an advocate for you. And so it's really important to build that relationship from the onset as you're looking to start a business.
Perfect. Nicole, we just have a few minutes left here. I want to note, though, I know that there are specific programs out there for women, minority-owned businesses. Can you speak a minute to around what advantages there may be or what opportunities there may be for women or minorities, specifically for lending options?
Well, there are, there are grants out there that you can, research in terms of specifically for women. It's going to vary by state. Yeah. You'll want to do your research. Again, your local SCORE office or SBA office can give you some resources for grants. And then loans that are out there that are specifically for women. There is an option to get an MBE certification. And so that is something that you can also research with your SCORE office to be able to get that certification, which will allow you to get some of those contracts and things like that, especially in the construction space. Mm-hmm. It makes you are more of like a go-to person or a preferred provider for the different services that you offer. And so that's something that I definitely recommend that you do some research and take the steps necessary to get that certification.
Absolutely. Nicole, these are just our moments of wow. There's like 10 more questions I want to ask, but we don't have time. So if someone wanted to reach out to you or just find more information about what you shared today, where should they go?
I can give you my information. Feel free to call me, text me, email me. I am, a resource. Even if it's just some questions that you might have, I'm definitely happy to give you some guidance. Can't cover everything in this short period, right? Yes. And it's an individual case by case basis. Mm-hmm. And so my email address is Nicole, Nicole.Dillard, like the store, Dillard, at usbank.com. And my phone number is 980-210-1156. Like I said, feel free to reach out to me at any time. I'm definitely happy to be a resource.
You've been amazing today, Nicole. Thank you so much for the information that you provided, the access to information and yourself, because it takes both. You need to know what you need to know, but you need the people who know what you don't know. So thank you for both of those today. For those of you who joined us for this moment of wow, thank you for your time. Excellent resource. We are partners and we bank with U.S. Bank, and we chose them because they are an organization that gives back to the community. And so we are grateful for this giving back that you've done for us today, Nicole. Celebrating Women in Construction Week, it is a pathway to entrepreneurship. You don't have to be perfect, but you do need to be prepared. Thank you for joining us. We look forward to more conversations in the future.